Baki Beti is Mufti's poster girl. That's right. The state marks the much wanted Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao campaign in Kashmir with terror patron Asia Andrabi as a poster girl, as a de facto ambassador sharing the stage with Saint Teresa, Indira Gandhi, Kiran Bedi, and several other leading Indian women icons. Can you believe it? In a landmark ruling, the Supreme Court passes order recognizing rapes on minor wives in India. Marital rape on women less than 18 is now a crime in this country.
We don't agree having fixed 18 as an age of age for marriage of girls. It's not acceptable in Islam.
Isn't it just disgusting, clerics and representatives of the Muslim community back child marriage, want age to be fixed at 15? Are minors sex objects for clerics and others conservatives? Four pictures on your screen aptly explain the utter apathy the common man has to face in India. This Bengaluru resident was almost run over with his wife and minor child when his bike, his motor scooter, turned turtle because of a pothole. Buses and trucks right behind them almost run them over. Veteran actor Anupam Kher succeeds controversial Gajendra Chauhan as the chairman of India's premier film institute, the FTII. Will Kher live up to the expectations of students who accuse the government of cherry-picking individuals aligned to their thinking? It's judgment day tomorrow in the Allahabad High Court, which will decide the fate of Arushi's parents who have appealed against their conviction in the chilling murder case. Asia Andrabi is a terror agent. She's a known India beta. She not just hoists the Pakistan flag, but also celebrates Pakistan terror. But in my hands is a poster. A poster that celebrates the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao campaign. This has been put up outside a government function that was called specifically to honor Indian women icon. What does this poster show and depict? It depicts the Chief Minister of the state, Mehbooba Mufti. It depicts Indira Gandhi, India's first woman Prime Minister. It depicts Kiran Bedi, Lata Mangeshkar. It depicts Kalpana Chawla, Saint Teresa, Mother Teresa, Sania Mirza, several others who have shown like beacons, not just in this country, but internationally because of their achievements. Curiously, strangely, shockingly, there is another addition to this list. If you can see here, the face belongs to Asia Andrabi, the founding leader of the Dukhtaran-e-Millat, a banned terror organization. Yes, she's sharing space. She's sharing space with India's greatest women icons. This is what it has come down to in Jammu and Kashmir. I want us to now ponder some hard facts. Let's look at some of those hard facts, because on your screens will be an absolutely accurate depiction of what Asia Andrabi stands for. She is one of the most vocal votaries of Pakistan in Kashmir. She hoists the Pakistani flag on Pakistan's National Day, and she burns the Indian tricolor on India's Independence Day. Let's look at the other hard fact which is going to come up. Asia Andrabi hails terrorist Hafiz Saeed the butcher of 2611, is her proclaimed brother. That individual, sitting in Islamabad, protected by the Pakistani state, gives a number of sermons where he hails Asia Andrabi as his sister and also cohort in the battle against the Indian state. Asia has pledged to separate Kashmir from India. She celebrates the murder of Indian braves. And she is under investigation today for being a conduit between Pakistan's dalals and the Pakistani deep state. I want to play out a voice recording, a sound recording, captured from a tape of Hafiz Saeed, the Lashkar-e-Toyba chief, the butcher of India's braves, and the mastermind of the 2611 attack, to demonstrate just how close Asia Andrabi, who shares space with Mother Teresa in a Kashmir government projection campaign for Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. She shares space with Indira Gandhi, Kiran Bedi, as I said, Lata Mangeshkar. This is what Hafiz Saeed has to say about this woman. It will shock you.
इसी बहन आसिया इंद्राबी का फोन आया और कह रही थी कि मेरे भाइयों, पाकिस्तानी भाइयों, हम जिस मुसीबत में हैं, मैं पूछना चाहती हूं कि मेरे पाकिस्तानी भाई कहां हैं। मेरे सारे साथी जो मीटिंग में मसरूफ थे, सब ने कहा सब काम छोड़ो, मीटिंग का एजेंडा खत्म, अपनी बहन की आवाज पर हमें लबैक कहना है इंशाअल्लाह। फौरन फैसला हुआ और कश्मीर कारवां की तैयारियां उसी मीटिंग के अंदर शुरू हो गई। ये सिर्फ 3 दिन के अंदर अंदर अल्लाह के फजल करम से इसकी तैयारी हुई और जिस अंदाज से ये कारवां चला, जितने जज्बों से चला, वो मेरा ख्याल है इस हाल में बैठे हुए बहुत सारे भाइयों ने अपनी आंखों से देखा।
There you heard him. Eulogizing Asia Andrabi. I don't have to say this, Hafiz Saeed is saying so. He is the one who has established her credentials as an anti-India voice of sedition. I want to ask some very basic questions. Isn't it an absolute insult to India, absolute insult, that Asia Andrabi today is being celebrated as one among India's greatest women icons? Sonam Mahajan joins us. Tariq Fateh is there with us also. Doesn't really need an introduction. Is an activist from Pakistan who is seeking today refuge in Canada. Is a citizen of that country also, if I'm not mistaken. And also with us is Babar Qadri, a lawyer from the Valley, who will no doubt today criticize me for taking on the state, for projecting this absolute misanthropic Pakistani stooge. I want to first begin with you, Sonam Mahajan. What goes through your mind when you see something like this?
Well, first of all, let's try to understand who Asia Andrabi is and what her contributions have been. Her husband is a terrorist. He's been in the jail for last 23 years. She's currently in jail, and her other contributions are her duplicity. She has secured an Indian passport for her son. Her oldest son is studying in Malaysia. He is the captain of the cricket team of his university. Younger son is in Kashmir doing well. And what Mrs. Andrabi does is she gives stones to the common Kashmiris and mobilizes them against India. So she is not just a fundamentalist, she is basically a terrorist, and she has been quite vocal about it. Another contribution of her has been trying to instill some sense of modesty, which she thinks is basically sense of modesty, but
yes.
But she has been wanting the Kashmiri woman to be clad in a curtain and dressed like bean bags. So these are the kind of things she has been doing. Now she is in jail, and the government, they say this poster has been backed up by the government. If she is such an icon of woman empowerment, what is she doing in the jail? That is my first question. Secondly, why did she even appear on the poster? And then, I mean, look at the other people who are on the poster. Who is Asia Andrabi to be there? Have we come down to this, that we are bringing a terrorist into mainstream? So BJP has a lot of answering to do here, because they have a government in the state. So my first question goes to them. If you have somebody from the BJP, I would like to seek an answer from them.
Well, yes, we will come to that. We will come to that. But I want to bring in Babar Qadri. Now, Babar Qadri, tell me, Babar Qadri, do you believe that Asia Andrabi, with all her qualities, abundantly anti-Indian, abundantly terror sympathetic, abundantly misanthropic, deserves to be treated like an icon, sir? And for which Kashmiri woman would a terrorist, sir, be an icon? Would an individual who goes against the spirit of Kashmiriyat be an icon? And
may I talk now?
One second. For which mother in Kashmir would a woman who gives stones to their children to throw, and in turn also get killed in police action, be an icon? Answer me this question, Mr. Qadri.
Rahul, first of all, I may tell you, this time, under present circumstances in Kashmir, this slogan Beti Bachao or Beti Padhao is not matching the circumstances.
Listen, you first answer the question I've asked you, Mr. Qadri. Are you in favor of this projection of a terrorist who is in jail?
Yeah.
Of a woman who's married to a terrorist who is in jail?
First, you should be ashamed of...
I'm asking you.
You should be ashamed of Sajjad Loon, whom you co-opted and corrupted and made him as minister. It is his department who has, you know, made this, you know, hoarding.
I'm asking you.
Second question, whatever is moral in India, that may be immoral in India, in Kashmir, and whatever
yeah,
is
why?
Moral,
Kashmir is supposed to be in outer Kashmir, space or something, Mr. Qadri? Is Kashmir in outer space? What is moral? Are you telling me?
That modesty, what modesty
Rahul,
you saying?
I have a question here. Culture,
yeah, I have a question. Come in with your question. You have all rights to ask.
No. Yes. If Kashmir is different from India, why does Asia Andrabi's son has secured, he has secured an Indian passport, he has traveled to Malaysia on Indian passport. If Kashmir is a country on its own, why do these people need the Indian passport? Why this duplicity? Why this duality?
Answer.
Yes, I will answer.
Qadri,
I will
and tell
answer.
Us, do you also
the
have
way,
an Indian passport? Because you sound
yeah.
like a complete separatist.
Yeah, do a passport of your own. Why do you need the Indian passport?
If you're so opposed to the Indian state, and if you want Kashmir to be handed over to Pakistan, and if you think Kashmir is a foreign land, why do you hold a passport?
The same privileges were used by Indian leaders.
Qadri, do you have, Mr. Qadri, do you have an Indian passport? I'm asking you.
Yes, the same way.
Why?
The same way.
Give it up.
The way.
As a mark of protest, tear up your passport, give it up.
Why should I give it up?
Why should you? Because, no, one second. I'll tell you one thing.
We will have
no, I'll
passport.
Tell you one thing. Mahatma Gandhi didn't have a British passport, sir. Let me tell you.
Then
exactly.
On which passport he was traveling and travel? What were the travel routes?
He did not travel on any English passport. Let me tell you this. No. So if you think you're some like Mahatma Gandhi kind of character, give up your credentials. Give up your credentials.
There were always travel documents.
No, I'm asking you. I'm asking you. No. One second. That's a very different thing that you're talking about. I am referring to you taking the oath, swearing by the Indian constitution. That's when you get a passport. Why does Asia Andrabi, for a foreign travels, then need a foreign passport?
It's an
Indian passport.
The moment
if she calls India a foreign country, why does she need the passport of a foreign country? I'm asking you.
Own passport. and we will travel. We will love to travel on our own passport.
You see, that's the problem. That's the problem. You want it both ways.
That's the problem.
The best
that's
of both worlds.
You want to have imperialism.
I want to bring in Tariq Fateh. I want to bring in Tariq Fateh today.
You want to have us as slaves.
Who today that's is feeling sorry for you, sir? Let me bring in Mr. Tariq Fateh. Mr. Tariq Fateh.
Tariq Fateh is a bagoda of Pakistan. He's a bagoda drunkard. How can he teach me nationalism?
No, no, listen. If you're here to insult people, I'll throw you out. Don't insult people.
I am ready, but
don't insult people.
He cannot teach me nationalism.
No, no, don't
he
insult people.
Me.
No,
he
no, one second.
Me.
Do not sit
he
here
cannot
and insult people.
He cannot
if you don't
he
have
he
a. No, no, if you don't
he
have.
Has
no,
no,
one second.
Right
if you don't have a disposition, sir,
he has no right
which
to
makes you amenable
what,
to debate, then you can leave the show. I have no problems with it. 1 minute. Mr. Tariq Fateh, please come.
I have no
Can you
no
please keep quiet, Mr. Babar Qadri? Someone is being asked a question. Have the decency and the courtesy if in your so-called foreign country, this
okay.
is the level of decorum, God help you. Because then you're not
he
Mr. Babri, but you're Mr. Barbarian. Now,
he
1 minute.
Not even
Let me go across to Mr.
He,
no, 1 minute. Let me go across to Mr. Tariq Fateh.
You invite hired person.
1 minute, 1 minute. Mr. Fateh, go ahead.
I feel sorry for this guy. You know, if I was anyone in India, I would just take him to the line of control, take Andrabi, take all these vermin that suck on India's resources and live off it, and just hand them over to the Azad Kashmir. Let them go over there. Why are they living in the evil Republic of India? The hatred for Hindus, the hatred for non-Muslims.
We are not living in India. We are living on our own soil, that's Kashmir.
Why don't you, Mr. Qadri, give him time.
Yeah. Why don't you just cross the line of control and go to Azad Kashmir? Why do you bother? You hate the land. You hate the place from where Karkatoa civilization was born. You have contempt for Hindu pandits. You have contempt for Hinduism. You hate India. And yet you sit there like scavengers, you know? You're like termites.
Tariq,
of course
are you
I'm Hindu. Of
Tariq,
course I'm Hindu.
Are you Hindu?
Every Indian is a Hindu.
You are. Okay. Are you Brahmin?
Yeah. You think I came from some Arab horse?
Are you Brahmin?
Or from central? You think, like you, I came with Timur? You think I'm a product of rapists and plunderers like Muhammad bin Qasim? Shame on you that you are proud of people who
you
plundered the West
yourself.
Bank.
You
are live
exposing
in?
Yourself. Go on
of course I'm
yourself.
Exposing myself.
Go on exposing
what
yourself.
What is wrong with exposing myself? And how do we know, by the way, how do we know that woman in the burqa is actually Andrabi? She could be Mirwais, I don't know. Yes. Anybody wearing a burqa getting
You ask Sajjad Loan, who is the minister of this social welfare department.
I don't know. Maybe it is you.
Why he has got her photo there?
Qadir Sahab, maybe it is you wearing the burqa.
I am minister.
Are you insensitive? Muhammad was in a burqa. All your heroes that ever entered the sacred subcontinent were in a burqa. You plundered, you looted, you raped, you destroyed, you emptied out. All
That's
of Hindustan.
So vast majority of Indian subcontinent converted to Islam. That's why
really?
So vast majority of a population.
Mr. Qadri, there is a simple solution for all of this. Go across to Pakistan, live a life there, celebrate the diversity of Pakistan, and while you're at it, also get shot.
Into Hindu and Muslim.
Get shot there for protesting. For
no,
more
no,
rights,
no, no.
because that's what happens.
Let him vegetate over there.
Yeah.
Let him stay there. Not a single Pakistani Kashmiri is allowed to speak Kashmiri. Let them go there.
No, they don't
Let
want
go.
To go there because they know that the Pakistani Punjabi will give them the hiding of their lives like they gave the Bangladeshis, the East Pakistanis were given the hiding of their lives. Their rights were snatched away from them, so much so that they formed their own country. Now these chaps here, who live off India, who are actually today being allowed to speak by an extremely tolerant Indian state are abusing their freedom and, most importantly, don't have the gumption to go across and live under the Punjabis of Pakistan. Nawaz Sharif, sir, will give you a kick. We'll give you a kick and shove you into a couple of refugee camps. That's what will happen to you.
I have my own nation, the Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, yes, we have seen it. Half your nation is with Pakistan under their... No, no, under their complete control, domination. The biggest colonialist is an invader of Indian land. And half of that land is now gone to the Chinese. Mr. Qadri, why don't you denounce Pakistan and China, who have taken over half of Kashmir? Why don't you? How can he bite the hand that feeds him? How can he bite the hand that feeds him? That's the problem. Now, 1 minute. There are reactions coming in on this big story. The Bharatiya Janata Party reacting. Let's listen in.
All separatists, all hardcore separatists are behind the bars. NIA has cracked down. ED has cracked down. Asia Andravi, he herself is behind the bar. She is in jail. Our government never budged before the pro-Pakistani elements. And see, in days to come, I have spoken to the Honorable Deputy Chief Minister and also the Honorable Social Welfare Minister Sajjad Lon Saab, and he assured that all the government officials, those will be found having hands in glove in hatching this conspiracy, will be taken to task. This is very serious matter, and all conspirators and culprits will be booked under sedition charges.
Sonam Mahajan, I hope you have your answer. The BJP taking an extremely hawkish line there, saying that any individual who is found guilty and they're going to get to the bottom of this will be booked for sedition. Do you endorse this, Ms. Mahajan?
Well, only the time will tell if they are really going to walk the talk or it is just going to stay in on news channels, because they are in the government and they can't always have their reactionary politics. What were they doing? Why were they not knowing that something like this is going to happen? Are they just there for the sake of it? Are they really the part of the government? And this is not the first time something like this has happened. We have Mehbooba Mufti and Asia Andrabi on the same poster. Are they lightening these two? Even if it's just the PDP to do this, so will PDP really stand up and, you know, clear their stand if they really see Mehbooba
Well,
Mufti
they haven't spoken to us
Andrabi
just as of now.
People who have the
Ms.
same
Mahajan, ideology. They haven't spoken to us. We will elicit responses from them because an inquiry needs to be ordered as to who dared to equate a terrorist with India's foremost women icons. We're going to take a short break. When we return to a dramatic debate that is unfolding on the back of a Supreme Court path-breaking watershed landmark judgment. We come out to that. Don't go away. Court's landmark verdict has set up a major nationwide debate. It ruled today that sex with minor wives is rape. It is illegal. In the process, the top court overruled the center, which had taken a contrary stand because it felt that it would upend a socio-economic reality that would lead to an irretrievable breakdown in several marriages between older men and minor girls. The center, however, has accepted the verdict. It says it is going to stand by the Supreme Court's ruling. But the Supreme Court's order has ruffled feathers in a section of the minority community. Clerics have, in fact, remonstrated, demanding that instead of the Supreme Court declaring this illegal, they should, in fact, lower the age of marriage to 15. Now, this is shocking for a variety of hard facts, and they're going to be up on your screens. 1 in 3 child brides across the world are from India. So a third of child brides in the world are from India. 47% of the girls are married before turning 18 in India, and therefore they have no consent or no capacity, because they are not adults, to consent or even have an understanding of sex, and therefore could be exploited. 75% of child brides from the weaker sections. That's right. So there is ample room here for exploitation. Some of them are sold for money to rich older men, just for their pleasure. 48% of child brides hail from rural areas. The same set of people who are arguing for triple talaq are today seeking the continued exploitation of minor girls. Now, what ideology, what God would sanction this perversion? Well, there are several individuals who believe that it's their God-given right, and I say this with deliberation, to violate girls as young as 15, even though the legal age of marriage is 18. That's right, because their personal laws allow that. What has the Supreme Court said? Let's pull out that. The Supreme Court has said that sex with minor wife is rape. The age of consent for girls is 18, rape law exception discriminatory. The clerics, however, feel quite differently. They say the age of consent in many European nations is 14. Girls mature at the age of 13, can take decisions, so they must be allowed to have sex when they're technically only children. The SC order, they say, infringes on Muslim personal laws. That's right. The Supreme Court's judgment mentions four very interesting points. Rape law exception is discriminatory, capricious, arbitrary. Rape law exception, contrary to other statutes that the Constitution has defined, the law defines. The rape law caveat violates girl child's bodily integrity and social justice laws not implemented in the right spirit, and therefore it has intervened. Some basic questions need to be asked tonight. Can sex with minor brides be justified under any circumstances? Those are the questions we're going to pose in just about a minute. Are clerics standing up for pedophilia when they argue for lowering the age of marriage? That's the second big question, and it is perhaps the most controversial one. Is Muslim personal law allowing for marriage of minors above Indian constitution? That is a fundamental aspect. And is exploitation of minors being given cover under the garb of personal laws? Let's throw this open tonight. With us is Ilyas Shafruddin, Islamic scholar, Ahmed Ayaz, secretary of the Muslim Personal Law Board from Kashmir. Also with us, Tariq Fateh and Amina Sherwani. Amina Sherwani, before I come to you, let's ask some of your co-travelers what they actually believe. And why is it that they oppose the Supreme Court's path-breaking, landmark, progressive judgment? Ilyas Shafruddin, would you like to explain your stand tonight?
See, in India nowadays, according to the survey done, girls as young as in the class 10th are getting sexually active. Unfortunately, the Supreme Court does not have any problem with those girls who are getting sexually active with their consent in class 8, 9, 10. But unfortunately, the same girls, when they are getting married with the consent of the parents and their own consent, Supreme Court is having a problem and their marriage is consummated. So it's an ironical situation for me and for whole India that at one stage we are legalizing live-in relationship.
So do you think a 9-year-old girl...
No, 1 minute. We are trying to ban...
Shafruddin.
We are trying to ban something very legal.
1 second. Before you accuse the Indian state of infringing your right to rape young girls, I just want to ask you a simple question.
I'm not accusing, I'm just showing a mirror.
1 second, sir. 1 second. A 9-year-old girl who is bequeathed to a 55-year-old man, when she attains puberty at the age of 13, finds herself being raped, Do you think she's in a position to decide for herself, sir? Would it be consent that you are talking about?
Her father got married, and 9-year-old girl.
So she's the property of some other man.
In Saudi Arabia.
No, so she is. No, so she's a body
to, understand
to
the
be passed from one individual, perhaps even sold from one individual to another.
The girls of India.
Sir, where have you left your mind?
Rahul, I would like to come in here.
Mr. Shafruddin, where have you left your mind? Is a young girl the property
she
of her father
with the husband for 10 years.
To be done
she happily lived
no no to be done what
years.
What the
she
man desires
problem, you are having problem and buffoons like Tarefada are having problems
sir yeah, are you completely are you completely Neanderthalic
Rahul,
sir
don't rape young girls I have a problem
Rahul,
are you a Neanderthal 1 minute let me ask I'm shocked actually. I cannot believe.
Rahul, could I come in here?
I cannot believe I'm having a debate with an individual who thinks it's okay for a man to pick up his 9-year-old and throw her into an illicit relationship with a 55-year-old so that she is raped.
It's not illicit.
And he has no problem with that. This is Mr. Shafruddin. Ilyas Shafruddin, who calls himself an Islamic scholar. Okay. Amina Sherwani wants to come in. Amina Sherwani. I'm a bit appalled.
Ilyas,
I don't know.
Ilyas Saifuddin does not know the first thing about Islam. The first thing Islam says is that only two consenting adults can get married. Nobody is an adult at 9 years old. Nobody is an adult at 12 years old. Nobody is an adult at 14 or 15 years old. You become an adult. You be quiet, you foolish man. An adult only after you have attained puberty. Now, puberty is a process that takes 4 years to complete. It may begin at the age of 10 or 12 years. It will complete by the age you are 16 or 17 years old. It does not complete at 13, 14 or 15. Therefore, 18 years is the perfect age, which is recommended by our constitution. It is also recommended by Islam. If these foolish men would bother to read the Quran, they would understand. They do not bother to read.
Show me a single verse from the Quran and the Hadith.
Show
me a single verse from the Quran and Hadith. You are a liar.
And by the way, consensual sex between teenagers is even permitted in Islam. So you cannot talk about forcing young girls to marry 50-year-old men.
Show me a single
Islam says if you feel you are an adult at 15 or 16, you may find yourself a suitable partner who does not have to be 55 years old and a maulana.
Like Tarek Fatah, don't learn Islam from Tarek. Like Tarek Fatah, don't learn Islam from Aris's gurus. Learn Islam from Quran Hadith.
No, no, gentlemen, 1 minute.
One second.
Miss Sherwani, Mr. Shafruddin and Miss Sherwani, let's not speak over each other. Now, Mr. Shafruddin, 1 minute. You need to allow some other people to speak. I know, sir, that your lust for prepubescent girls is perhaps driving you.
She is speaking lies
so much
along with you.
Is driving you so much today.
She is lying.
Is exciting you
lying.
So much today that you're frothing at the mouth.
It's not
but
lust.
Please,
it's the right
excuse
of the girl.
Me, Mr. Shafruddin, please keep
it's,
a little.
It's the right
calm.
Of the girl, not lust.
Please, please, please.
Right.
I beg you, sir. Don't allow your lust to get the better of you. Your rights to rape are not being
it's
snatched
not lust.
Away from you.
It's right.
No, no. 1 minute, please.
It's my
just
legal
calm
right.
Down.
I'm not running
ashram. You're not representing. No, no, you're not representing.
So
you're doing a disservice to your religion. I'm pretty sure that this is not endorsed by the Quran. I'm quite certain about that. I'm not an expert.
It doesn't matter, sir.
1 minute.
Rahul, it
not
doesn't matter.
By the Quran
you
at
don't
all.
Know the chapters of the Quran. Learn Quran first.
It doesn't
you
matter.
You might be right, sir.
Learn Quran first.
But if this is the case, then
we
I think
the
that reforms
of the
are required.
Quran. We have all read the Quran much more than you have and understood it better than you have.
Show me a single verse from the Quran if you are the truth.
Okay, but Mr. Shafruddin, if you stop screaming,
show me a single verse from the Quran where it says that 18 years is one more adult.
Raise my voice and I'm not.
Are you are lying like Tarek
I'm not disposed
to
that.
He's a liar. You are a liar.
Okay, Mr. Shafruddin, calm down. Can you allow other people to speak? I will give you a chance. Please, I assure you. Please cooperate with me. Please, sir. Okay, Mr. Tarek Fateh, what would you like to say to this gentleman first?
That he lives in a nation state that is governed by a constitution. He is not living in a caliphate, and I really don't care whether his Sharia allows him or doesn't allow him. He's propagating rape and marital rape at that, and he's quite happy with that because for the last few hundred years, Muslim men with money have been buying slaves and raping them. They do not find it disgusting that Arab sheikhs come and buy 15-year-old girls. Please keep quiet.
Mr. Shafruddin, let him speak. Let him speak. I request you again. Let him speak, please. Don't disrupt the debate.
But we are
everyone has a point to make.
Religion.
One minute.
You are not talking religion. You are talking of rape.
I have a point to make.
You are talking of rape and you are endorsing.
We are not in the caliphate. We know that too. But the point is, we have equal rights. We are free to profess. We are free to.
Ahmed Ayaz Saab, 1 minute. Aap jara kisi aur ko, let somebody else also speak. Ahmed Ayaz, please. I request you, sir. Please cooperate. Mr. Tariq Fateh is winding up. He's making a few points. Yes, Mr. Fateh, go ahead, sir.
I'll
have to lower your fader, Mr. Ayaz. There's no point. Don't force me into doing something undemocratic. Yes, go ahead.
The issue here is that the consensual age of sex, whether in international law, does not allow for adults to interact with minor children. So if a 15-year-old young girl and boy are having sex, they can't be prosecuted. But if a 19-year-old man is having sex with a child, it is statutory rape. That is what Muhammad Ali Jinnah escaped when he ran away with his friend's 16-year-old daughter and raped her for 2 years. And that is the hero that these people still look forward to. They have been destroying the lives of Muslim girls for a few hundred years. Thank goodness. And by the way, let me assure you, just today, the Egyptian criminal system has gone to Parliament and asked for the criminalization of any adult who marries a woman below the age of 18. They have gone one step beyond the Indian government. This is the same Egypt from where all these people take out 500-year-old books and thump it on India.
Okay, let me go across to Ahmed Ayaz now. Ahmed Ayaz, are you advocating the right to rape, sir, today?
Does not say that you can marry children.
Amina,
it does not let you marry children. This is an aberration.
Okay, Amina Sherwani, I'll come to you. I'll come to you, please. Let me first hear everyone out. We haven't given Mr. Ahmed Ayaz his time.
Yes.
Are you advocating the right to rape, sir? Do you want 55-year-old men to marry 9-year-olds and wait for them till they turn 13 and rape them? Is that what you want, sir? Ayaz Saab, can you hear me? Okay, I think we might have lost Mr. Ayaz.
I think Ayaz Saab has run away and I'm glad he has run away or maybe the cat's got
his tongue. Mr. Shafruddin, would you like to answer since you're raising your hand?
Yeah. Actually, Tariq Fateh and Sherwani have learned Islam from the Nagpur headquarters of RSS. Because of that, they don't know Quran or the Hadith. They get paid over there every month also, I believe.
You keep quiet. I am a much better Muslim than you can ever hope to be in your dreams.
The Quran never says that 18 years is the age of adulthood. The Quran allows the girl and the father of the girl to go ahead and get married if she is mentally and physically fit.
Sherwani, let him speak.
You should
Mr. Shervani, let him speak.
Mr. Shafruddin
speak. Later on, listen to
me. There is no need to let him speak.
Nobody has a point of view. He has a point of view. We may not like his point of view, but he has a right to express himself. This is still a democracy, ma'am. And people need to hear these misogynist minds. We must expose them. The only way you can defeat them is by exposing them first.
Men do not.
In ashram, small girls.
Ma'am, I know. I know you're ashamed of these men. I know it makes you really upset. But you need to hear this voice, because this is the voice that advocates for the right to rape minors. These are pedophiles. These are pedophiles.
No,
1 minute. These are pedophiles. There is no other word for it.
The worst narrative in the world.
There you go, ma'am. This is the reality.
Take them to jail. Don't bring them into studios.
Have
them arrested.
We are not.
But ma'am, for what crime?
Ma'am,
they are saying that their religion actually allows them to rape minor girls. girls.
We are not Alhamdulillah.
This is the problem.
Yeah, if you use
no, no, Quran says that marriage itself says that an agreement between two adults.
Because you are a better
and adulthood will be decided based on the mental and physical fitness, not on the age.
Rahul, may I come in?
Sir, please. Please,
so
please.
Rahul, may I come in?
Yes, Mr. Ahmed, are you advocating the right to rape minor girls, prepubescent girls? Do you want to marry girls that are 9 years old and wait for them to grow up because their father has dumped them at your door, sold them to you and then raped them? I'm asking you. I ask, sahab, mujhe aap jawab dijiye. Answer me today. Shameful.
For us, the marriageable age defined for girls is once they achieve the age of puberty. So it can be even at the age of 10 also.
Oh God.
It can be 18 also, it can be 16 also, it can be 13 also.
Only when a girl has completed
the most important
puberty,
thing in Islam is that the girl should achieve the age of puberty and it cannot be less than that.
And everybody has to be
very disturbing.
After she achieves the age of puberty,
nobody attains puberty at 13 or 12 years of age.
This is very disturbing.
It is a 4-year-old process.
How can you look at a 10-year-old girl, sir? How can you look at a 10-year-old child?
Whatever may be
I think I should allow you to come in because we need the voice of reason here. These men are disgusting. They are advocating the violation of 10-year-old girls.
Can you put tape on their mouths?
I don't know what to do, but you please come in. Let's listen to the other point of view.
On their mouth because
sir,
you
have some shame.
And it can be at any point.
So that
sir, what
can
kya rahe, have some
Quran
shame.
Says.
Please, one minute.
Karo.
I don't know. And you are the secretary of the Muslim Personal Law Board,
now,
sir, from
Quran
Jammu and Kashmir.
The Quran says
who says a 10-year-old girl, 9-year-old girl is okay as long as, you know, she is...
That's what I say.
She's
your only
puberty.
Concern is sex.
I say age of puberty.
And this man is disgusting.
It is age of puberty at any point of time. Whenever the age of whenever one reaches the age of puberty,
so what differentiates you between those ISIS?
You are disgusting, both of you.
Shocking.
I mean, I am shocked. On the one hand, we have the Sangheed saying that women belong into the kitchen. On the other hand, we have these Muslim gangs saying that women can be married off at the age of 14 and 12. And we may have sex with older women. I do not understand where my country is going.
Where are about it? Once a girl reaches the age of puberty,
that is not going to take you anywhere.
I'm lowering your faders. I want Ameena Sheikh to speak. Ameena Sherwani, please go ahead. Sorry, Ameena Sherwani, please go ahead.
Rahul, the Quran clearly says, the Quran very clearly says that only two consenting adults can get married. The description of adulthood in the Quran is after you have attained your puberty. Puberty, normally any doctor will tell you, begins for children at 11 to 12 years of age and it finishes. It's a 4 to 5 year process, which in some children it can happen a little earlier, some children a little later, but no one attains puberty before the age of 15 or 16. So therefore 15 and 16 is the barest minimum. Our constitution says 18 years of age and puberty completes by the time we are 17, 18. We are still in school in this country. We are doing class 12.
Precisely.
We are children.
Rahul, I have to
school girls are sexually
okay.
Is a
perfectly reasonable.
Tariq Fatah also wants to add a point.
Children will have experimental sex with each other. Young boys and young girls and young boys and young boys. There are homosexuals, there are gay people, there are heterosexual people, and children begin experimental
sex. So what is wrong with gay sex? What are you saying, sir? What is wrong with you?
And the Quran has no objection to that. The Quran
have you
wants
come out
you
of a
to
cave?
Be sexually active. It wants you to be reproductive. It wants you to learn
where
the
have
ways
you come
of
out
the
of?
World. It permits young children to marry
you call yourself
each other
an Islamic
so
scholar,
desire.
Sir.
But it does not permit older men to come and pick up
I have to,
girls.
When they tell lies, I have to stop.
So, Quran is very modern in its outlook. It
okay, one minute. Ameena Sherwani, 1 second, please.
Not among older people and younger people.
Okay, Tariq Fateh also wants to make a point. Very valid points, I think, Ameena Sherwani has made tonight. Very valid points.
No
I want to bring in Tariq Fateh. 1 second. Ahmed Ayaz, you are making me sick, sir. Please. You think it's okay to have... You know,
Rahul, let me add
I don't,
some clarification
carnal knowledge
here.
Of a 9-year-old. I mean, I don't know where to start. So please, let's just Stop there, please, please.
These mullahs are not saying the same thing on TV which they wish to. They are quoting from Sharia law written 200 years after the Quran was revealed, in which it is said that the Prophet Muhammad first married Aisha when she was six and consummated her marriage at the age of nine. Oh, please keep quiet. Go back to Pakistan. Why did you stay here?
You are telling lies.
Yes. Please, can you cut his sound
out? Liar. Top class liar.
Mr. Shafruddin, 1 minute, please. Let him finish.
Remember, when you are going to die, you are going to die.
Sir, he's as much a Muslim as you are. He's making a point. Let him make the point.
No. Those who read the Quran and the Hadith are not Muslims. They are students of RSS.
Oh God, Rahul, can I
bring RSS is a top class buffoon, sold out prostitute.
Whether she was faithful to him. So when an old man...
Let me bring in
Amina Sherwani. Amina Sherwani.
Similar age groups should get married to each other.
Yes. So you're saying that an old man should not be getting married to
all men, including the Lord Brahma... Not at all. Older people, whether older women or older men, should not be exploiting younger people. We should be protecting younger people. We should be looking after younger people. We should be helping them to find mates of their choice and their age group. We should not be using them for self-gratification.
Marriage is not exploitation.
Muhammad, all his life, he doubted Aisha. He was unsure of himself whether he could satisfy such a young girl. Aisha was sick all her life. She was ill all her life.
Sherwani is speaking the language of Jews now. That's what I'm saying. This is not the Quran and the Hadith.
So it was wrong of Muhammad to have married Aisha.
It was wrong of the Prophet to have married Aisha.
No business to hand over his daughter to an older man.
Amina Sherwani, are you saying that it was wrong of the Prophet to have married Aisha?
Aisha's father had no business to hand over his daughter to an older man like this.
So
absolutely wrong.
Daughter is happy. She is afraid. The daughter Aisha was happy.
The 9-year-old
Aisha
girl
was very happy for 68 years.
She know what makes her happy or not.
Aisha died in 8 years of age. She was happy. And she is having the problem.
Anyone would be wanting to be married to a 60-year-old man, a 9-year-old? Would not even understand what marriage is.
She was happy. It's better than getting raped in the ashram.
No, sir. Absolutely. It's better than becoming a devdasi.
It is better than becoming a prostitute at a young age like it is happening in India today. Marriage is good. Marriage is good with the consent of the girl and the father.
How
marriage is good. But getting raped in ashrams and becoming a devdasi is very dangerous.
His mistake.
That is very dangerous.
Not ever. He could
Like Sherwani, 1 minute. You should
I'm loading the traders. I want Tariq Fateh to come in. He made a very interesting point. Tariq Fateh Saab, I think we lost you. I want you to come in and I want you to explain to some of your, you know, cohorts, co-religionists, if nothing else, why they are wrong.
They are wrong on multiple accounts because they manufactured Sharia law so that the caliphs of the time could indulge in pedophilia. Each one of these Umayyad and Abbasid Khalifas had close to hundreds of concubines. And those of them who wanted to have child sex invoked the Sharia law by saying there is a Hadith and by the Siratul Nabi that the Prophet did this. And therefore it justifies them to do it. Now today they come up and say, okay, this is part of Islamic. No. There is no mention of any age in the Quran. This was manufactured by the same type of mullahs in the 900s and 1000 and later on, who created grounds for sex slaves, for women that would be raped, and they kept them in the camps. Shah Wali Ullah took 300 women to Calcutta. That is our own history. How many girls were there in the Delhi courts of Muslim rulers? Young girls. That is how Muhammad Ali Jinnah got away with 16-year-old